वेलकम टू सिक्स्थ सेशन ऑफ यूनिट 5 इन मैकेनिकल मेजरमेंट्स। दिस सेशन इज अबाउट वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ हेयर हाइग्रोमीटर, हाइड्रोमीटर एंड मर्क्यूरी स्फिग्मोमैनोमीटर। कमिंग टू द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस सेशन, दिस सेशन कंसिस्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट वन इज वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ हेयर हाइग्रोमीटर, then working principle of hydrometer, and the last one is working principle of mercury sphygmomanometer. Let us see about working principle of hair hygrometer. Before knowing the principle of, or coming to the principle of hair hygrometer, first we should know about what is hygrometer. The hygrometer is a device which is used for measuring the relative humidity. The main types of hygrometer are hair hygrometer, electrical hygrometer, dew point hygrometer and psychrometer. Hair hygrometer is a type of hygrometer which uses human hair as a sensing element of the humidity. Certain hygroscopic materials, the hygroscopic means the substance which absorb water from its surroundings. The materials such as human hair, animal membranes, wood, paper, etc. undergo the changes in the linear dimension when they absorb moisture from the surrounding air. This change in the linear dimension is used as the measurement of humidity present in the air. Coming to the construction of hair hygrometer, the hair hygrometer consists of the hair, which is a humidity sensor, arm and linkage, a tension spring, a pointer which sweeps over a calibrated scale. The hair are arranged on a parallel beam and separated from each other to expose them to the surrounding air. As shown in the figure, the hair are arranged parallelly and exposed to the air. More number of hair are used to increase the mechanical strength. The hair arrangement is placed under a small tension by a tension spring. This hair arrangement is connected to an arm and link. The link in turn is attached to a pointer which moves over a calibrated scale of humidity. To measure the relative humidity, the air is made to surround the hair arrangement of the hygrometer. The hair absorb the moisture from the surrounding air and expand in the linear direction. As hair is a hygroscopic material, it expand due to the absorption of moisture. The expanded hair in turn move the arm and linkage. The link in turn moves the pointer on the calibrated scale. Thus, the humidity of air is measured directly on the calibrated scale of the hair hygrometer. This is how the relative humidity can be measured using a hair hygrometer. Coming to the working principle of hydrometer, the hydrometer is an instrument which is used to measure the relative density of liquids in open vessels. The relative density or specific gravity is defined as the ratio of density of a substance to the density of a reference material. For liquids, the reference material is water. The hydrometer works on the principle of buoyancy or Archimedes principle. Then, what is Archimedes principle? The Archimedes principle states that the upward buoyant force exerted on a body immersed in a fluid is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. In the figure, we can see there the Archimedes principle is illustrated with the figure. So the weight of the body is 5 kg. When the 5 kg weight is immersed in water, the buoyant or upward force exerted by the water is 2 kg. That is seen in the second figure, that is second jar. So the same weight of the water is displaced by the weight. So the in the figure you can see there, the weight of the water which is displaced is also equal to 2 kg. Coming to the construction of hydrometer, the hydrometer consists of a sealed hollow glass tube with wider bottom portion for buoyancy. In the figure there, you can see there is a float which is wider and meant for the buoyancy. Under the float, the weight is attached for the stability, which is nothing but a ballast such as lead or mercury for stability. Ballast means the heavy material which gives stability. Then above the float, there is a narrow stem with the graduations for measuring the relative density of the liquid. To measure the relative density of required liquid in an open vessel, the hydrometer is gently placed in the liquid until it floats freely in the liquid. The point at which the surface of liquid touches the calibrated stem of the hydrometer correlates to the relative density of the liquid in the open vessel. The depth to which the float of the hydrometer will sink depends on the density of the liquid. Greater the density of liquid, the lesser the depth to which the float sinks. In other words, lesser the density of liquid, more the depth to which the float of the hydrometer sinks in the liquid which is under measurement. That is how the relative density of the liquids is measured by hydrometer in an open vessel. Next, we shall see about the working principle of mercury sphygmomanometer. The sphygmomanometer is an instrument which is used to measure the blood pressure. The main types of sphygmomanometer are mercury sphygmomanometer, aneroid sphygmomanometer, and digital sphygmomanometer. The mercury sphygmomanometer is called so because it uses mercury manometer to measure and indicate the blood pressure. Coming to the construction of mercury sphygmomanometer, in the figure we can see there it is a mercury sphygmomanometer. The main parts of mercury sphygmomanometer are inflatable cuff, then squeeze type ball pump, needle type pressure release valve, and folding type mercury manometer. A stethoscope is used along with the mercury sphygmomanometer to listen arterial blood flows. The ball pump inflates the cuff with the air. The valve is used to release the pressure, and mercury manometer indicates cuff's pressure reading. In the figure we can see there, the cuff is connected to the squeeze ball pump through the hose. At the other side, the cuff is also connected to the mercury manometer through the hose. A stethoscope is used along with the sphygmomanometer to listen the sounds of the blood flow in the arteries. The arterial blood pressure reading consists of two numbers. One is for systolic pressure and another is for diastolic pressure. The systolic pressure refers to the contraction of the ventricles of the heart when the blood is forced from the heart into the arteries. In the figure, you can see the systolic phase. The green arrow mark shows that the heart is contracting during the systolic phase. The white arrow marks shows that the blood flows through the arteries when there is a rise in the pressure due to the contraction of heart during the systolic phase. The normal systolic pressure for the human beings is 120 mm of Hg. The diastolic pressure refers to when the heart is relaxed between the beats and ventricles are expanded during this phase. In the figure, you can see the diastolic phase. During diastolic phase, the heart relaxes and the blood pressure falls and the blood fills into the heart. In the figure, we can see the white arrow marks, which shows the filling of the heart with the blood. The diastolic pressure for normal human being is 80 mm of Hg. Coming to the working of mercury sphygmomanometer. To measure the blood pressure in human beings, the cuff is wrapped around an upper arm, roughly at the same vertical height as that of the heart. Then the cuff is inflated until the artery is occluded. Occluded means momentarily stop or block. The cuff is inflated so that the blood flow in the artery is momentarily stopped. Then, listening with the stethoscope to the brachial artery at the elbow, slowly the pressure is released from the cuff by opening the pressure release valve. As the pressure in the cuff falls, a whooshing or pounding sound is heard in the stethoscope. When the blood flow first starts again in the artery, the pressure reading in the manometer at which this sound began is recorded as systolic pressure. Then the cuff pressure is further released until the sound in the stethoscope is no longer heard. The pressure reading at this stage is recorded as diastolic pressure. The blood flow sounds are called as Korotkov sounds. The blood pressure is commonly stated as systolic over diastolic. For normal human being, the blood pressure is 120 over 80. The unit of blood pressure is millimeters of mercury. That is about the working principle of mercury sphygmomanometer. Coming to the summary of this session, the hair hygrometer is used to measure the relative humidity. In hair hygrometer, the human hair is used as sensing element of the humidity. The human hair expand linearly on absorbing the moisture from surrounding air. The expanded hair moves arm and linkage. In turn, the arm and linkage moves the pointer on the calibrated scale of the hair hygrometer. Thus, the humidity is measured using hair hygrometer. The hydrometer is an instrument which is used to measure the relative density of the liquids in open vessels. Hydrometer works on buoyancy or Archimedes principle. To measure the relative density of the liquid, the hydrometer is gently placed into the liquids until it flows freely in the liquid. The point at which the surface of the liquid touches the stem of the hydrometer correlates relative density of the liquid under measurement. Greater the density of the liquid, lesser the depth to which the float sinks. The mercury sphygmomanometer is used to measure the blood pressure. The mercury sphygmomanometer uses mercury manometer to measure and indicate the blood pressure. The stethoscope must be used along with the mercury sphygmomanometer to hear the sound of blood flow in the arteries. The blood flow in the arteries is momentarily stopped using inflated cuff. Then the pressure is slowly released in the cuff using pressure release valve, and with the stethoscope the first blood flow sound is heard with the stethoscope, and it is noted as systolic pressure. The pressure in the cuff is further released until no sound in the stethoscope is heard. And this pressure is noted as diastolic pressure. That's all about the working principle of hair hygrometer, hydrometer, and mercury sphygmomanometer. Thank you for watching this session.